So today I will be doing a review for you on this guy right here. This is from Graftobian, and this is their high definition color palette in neutral. Okay, so I got this stuff at IMATS. I had been looking into it for a little while, so I kind of already knew the information, but it's all good. So this is what it comes in. It's basically like a foundation palette, although you can totally use it as a concealer or anything that else you want, and it's a cream-based product, so it's a water-based cream. This is what it comes in. It looks like this, and it just slides out, and it has all the information here on the back. Let's see if it'll focus for you guys. A little bit. You can't really see here, but it just says Super Palette and Neutral. They have three. There's a neutral, there's a warm, and there's a cool. And then on the back, which is kind of nice, it shows color names. There you go. So that way, if you ever want to order the stuff separately, you can totally do that, which is nice. So for example, the shade that I use all over my skin is Bombshell. I do have it on right now. I have nothing else on my skin other than just a primer, the foundation, and I set it with a little bit of powder, which you're going to see at the end. But I didn't want to put anything else on, that way you can really, really see what the foundation looks like. So this is the front, and the back was what I just showed you. When you open it up, you get a mirror up top. And then you get all of these shades. Now, see this like totally gnarly stuff over here in the corner where, you know, in here? Basically, what they had told me at the IMATS counter is that's normal, that it's just how the pigment goes, blah, blah, blah. I actually had them open up another thing so I could see it, and they were all like that. So I'm just gonna take their word on it. So if you get this shipped to you or something and you see it that way, that's totally why. They unfortunately were not super helpful at IMATS, which I was kind of bummed about. The first person I talked to had no idea about the products at all, and she had to actually call somebody else over. And then that person didn't know what was going on. Basically, I was asking them questions, and the answer to everything was no. I'm like, well, is it water-based? No. Well, okay. And then I was like, well, say I use like a face and body or some sort of mixing medium to help, you know, dilute it or to change the tone a little bit. Can I do that? And he's like, no, you can't do that. You totally can. Whatever. But the product's good, so that's nice. But it comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times 3 is 18. So you get 18 shades right there. And they're really cool colors. Again, this is neutral, so they're going to be a mix of that yellow and the pink versus the warm palette and the cool palette. The cool one's going to be more pink. Warm palette, obviously, is going to be more yellow. But yeah, they're really, really good. You can see this is my shade that I keep digging into, which is their lightest one. I do like to mix it with the white face and body from MAC because it lightens it up just a little bit. This can look a little yellowy on my skin. I'm kind of picky about foundations as it is just because I'm paler, but on top of it, people have noticed it. So it's not like it's just me. It's I've worn it and people are like, something's different, or did you get a tan, which not a good compliment if you're a pasty. So yeah, really good. It lasts a long time too, which is nice. You can get super full coverage, you can get super sheer coverage. You can mix it with whatever you want. So say you want to, again, you can use the face and body, you could use a colored face and bodies, I mean, whatever you want to do. You can use the face and body mixing medium if you want to dilute it down a little bit. And after this, when I apply it, I'll show you kind of how to smooth it out a little bit with Fix Plus and a sponge, which you can use too. If you're super oily or super acne prone, you can mix it in with whatever you're using. So like say you're using this toner or something, you can mix a little bit of the acetone, or the toner in with it, and it's still gonna apply. You just only wanted to mix a little bit. Really good for photos. Yeah, just all around a really good thing to have, and it's great as concealers too. That's basically the main thing that I've been using it as, is concealers. I started out that way. Then when I realized I liked it, I moved to using it as foundations. So I have only tried this on myself as of this point right now. Now it's going to go into my kit. I like to try things out for a few weeks first. And I'll be using it on brides and all sorts of other things. But works really, really well. I definitely recommend it. Go to their website and you can check it out and see the other stuff that they have. You can buy these individual. So if you know your color, or say you don't need all of these shades, you can totally get this to try it out because it's pretty cheap to get all these. And then you can go from there and really get the shades you want. I think that is it. Kind of rambled for a second. Oh, one thing I do recommend too. Use a little spatula guy like this. if this is in your kit, to take the stuff out, because you're not going to be obviously using the whole well of one of these guys. So it's a lot better just to kind of scrape and get what you need, disinfect this, and then you can totally just store it right in here. Just way more sanitary, which is always nice. Especially, I'm totally OCD when it comes to cleanliness with cosmetics. But yeah, that's it. If you have any questions, totally let me know. And right now you're going to see a video of me applying it to the skin. All right, so to use this, I don't have anything on my skin right now except for a little bit of primer, so nothing going on. We're going to go in with the foundation colors. So I'm going to use this one that's kind of right up here in the top that you see I've been scraping from. And I'm only going to grab a really, really little bit with my little scraper spatula guy. And we're going to put this on. It's actually a little too much, but I'll kind of show you the amount that we're working with here, okay? So that's about how much we're using. And I'm just going to put that on my palette, okay? So I've got that tiny, tiny little bit there. I'm going to take another tiny little section, or I guess I could use it from there, and put that on the other side. This is going to be my concealer. This is going to be my all-over foundation. So for the concealer, I'm going to take a little bit of the white Face and Body from MAC, and we're just going to pop that right next to it. I'm going to hold that up. It's going to run, but just so you can see, there it goes. All right? So for this, I'm going to start with the concealer. It's really different as far as whether you want to start with concealer or not, but it's because I kind of want to lighten in here too at the same time, so it's like a 2-for-1 deal. And let's pull my hair back. Make sure all the primer's rubbed in. And I'm just going to apply that underneath the eye area. And then use my finger to kind of blend it out. If I was doing more full coverage, I totally just use the brush, but I'm just going to apply it here. For me, here, and then I like to apply some right here, just to brighten it. I'm going to go into that little section of foundation that we have right there, and I'm just going to take my foundation brush, and for this, we'll use it directly, although normally I would like to dilute it down. You can kind of see how it's already giving a full coverage. And I'm just going to apply this all over the face. Alright, so as you can see, I just kind of put it all over. I did use everything on that little spatula, and it gives a nice full coverage. And I can totally put more on if I want to, but, you know, just do whatever it is you want to do. For me, this is more than enough. Another thing you can do, too, is because it comes with literally all these different colors. Let me pull that out again to show you. You can go in and you can use colors to contour. You can use it to manipulate different things. Let's say I want to contour a little bit, not too much. We're going to go in. I'm going to go in with this kind of second color in. Grab a little bit of that, do the same thing, and then I'll apply it for contouring. All right, so to contour, you kind of want to go in, I mean, I'm sure you guys know the contouring, underneath the cheekbones. If you want to do there, you can do underneath the chin, you can do up in this area, you can contour the nose, you can pretty much do whatever you want. So I'm going to put a little bit kind of in the jaw area. Let's see if I can draw a line so you can see, there you go. And blend that in, and then you can always add more, but okay, let's do some lines. Hopefully you can see that we're going to do some right here. We're going to apply some right there. Contouring would also be here on the nose. And for me, I really don't dig heavy contouring just because I like to look as pale as I can, so I'm not going to use a whole lot. But there on the nose, another contouring would be right underneath the chin. And lastly would be here and here. So hopefully you can kind of see where I put everything, and now I'm just going to blend it all in. Okay, so the really mild contouring is done. You can kind of see it gave a little bit, but again, if you like heavier contouring, go with a darker color or put more on. And I wanted to show you this too, which is kind of nice. It's super humid right now, so I'm a little moist, I guess you could say. The stuff doesn't transfer. I mean, if you wipe up against something, yeah, but if you set with something else too, it's going to help stay. But just by itself, I'm just going to kind of push on the skin. You see how there's nothing on the paper towel? It doesn't transfer. So that's what's nice about it. So even though you're putting on like full coverage, your model or whomever's doing it, they're not going to get it on other people. So there's that. And say, for example, you put this on and you put way too much on. You had no self-control and you were doing super full coverage. Easy way to take it down is to take a sponge just like this. You can use a water, a hydrating spray. I'm just actually going to go in with Fix Plus. Spray the sponge just like that. Get it a little bit damp. You don't want it like crazy wet. And then you just kind of tap it on the skin. And that'll actually help to blend it all out, but it'll actually help to tone it down. So it takes a little bit off. And I don't know if you'll really be able to tell one side to the other, but you can up close. This side just still looks like makeup. Like, it's not bad or anything, but it looks like makeup. And this side just looks like skin. That's kind of what I go for, especially when I do people's makeup. I don't want it to look like, I don't know, heavy scoopable makeup on the face, but I like it to look more like skin. So voila, see, problem solved. And then you can totally set it with the powder, which I'm gonna do here. Okay, so to set this stuff, just go ahead and use whatever powder you like, but I'm gonna show you what I use all the time. Constantly, whenever I do this on other people, I use this stuff right here, which I'm using the lid. This is from Studio Gear. This color happens to be light. It's their Invisible loose powders. They have 3 shades. And then for me, and occasionally I'll use this on somebody if they're like super oily, is I also use the MAC Prep and Prime. I don't like this by itself. I don't know, the texture is just a little, it's not as smooth. But if you mix the two together, which, so this is, so that's the Prep and Prime with the light powder mixed together. Looks awesome. Let me find a brush real quick. Take that on a nice big soft brush and just push that in the skin. Use as much as you want. If it's super hot or humid like today, I'll use a little bit more in the morning because it'll catch all my awesome oiliness that happens later on. And remember, press, don't sweep across. Pressing is just gonna help to push it in and help it out a little bit more. Grab all that, and that's it. So that's basically the foundation overall. Like I said, super awesome, greatest concealer, great by itself. I mean, just totally use it for whatever you want. Really, really good, but I definitely check it out. And I think I said it earlier, but if not, this is the neutral palette, super neutral. So that's it. If you guys have any questions, anything like that, totally let me know, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.